Hey everybody, Vicky here from Tales from the Trails, and this game pulls on the heartstrings. Its name is Copycat, and you play a cat. You can do cat things, you can chase birds, you can climb trees, you can knock things over, but the story, oh my days, it hurts the heart, it really does, and we're going to take you through that just now. In a dimly-lit corner of a bustling city, a modest indie game studio quietly crafts something extraordinary. It's known as Copycat, and it starts as a straightforward concept but blooms into a profound narrative that draws players into the unique world. At the heart of this poignant tale is Dawn, a skeptical shelter cat with a fierce belief that she belongs to the wild. She's been through the system more than once, each time more determined to escape. Her spirit, untamed and raw, clashes with the walls of her confinement. And at this point we find Olive. She's a lonely older Australian lady whose heart aches from the disappearance of her beloved pet. She finds herself at the shelter, eyes locking with Dawn's defiant gaze. Despite Dawn's initial resolve to flee, something about Olive, her quiet sadness, her gentle demeanor, makes Dawn pause. What begins as a tenuous truce evolves into a deep bond. Olive's soft words and kind hands gradually draw and thaw Dawn's mistrust. They become two broken souls, mending each other's wounds, finding solace in shared moments and silent companionship. For the first time, Dawn actually feels a flicker of something that might be home. Unfortunately, the fragile piece does shatter when Olive falls ill and the loving daughter, I say this in air quotes, kicks you out. And she does some other nasty things as well. In the chaos that follows, a stray cat, eerily similar to Dawn yourself, sneaks into the home and slips into her place. Dawn is bewildered and feels betrayed, obviously. She finds herself back on the streets and the very freedom that she once craved is now cold and harsh reality. And as Dawn, you the player will embark on a journey with Dawn, wandering through the shadowy alleyways, scaling fences and leaping across rooftops. With every step, Dawn discovers the true meaning of home, not as a place but as a bond and a feeling. The game's pacing allows players to immerse themselves in the emotions of love, loneliness and the heart-wrenching act of letting go. Copycat features a fully voiced narrative with hours of heartfelt dialogue brought to life by a talented cast. The original score by Daniel Bunting underpins every moment, enhancing the emotional depth of the experience of the game. This game doesn't shy away from the heavy topics, including family trauma, abandonment, and emotional complexities. It's a reminder that in our darkest times, we are not alone. So if you're navigating difficult times, reach out to those around you. They are there to help you. Lean on your friends, family, or professionals. Take care of yourself, and remember, you can always come back to the game at your own pace if it is too difficult for you. And of course, if you've got a cat nearby, scoop them up, give them a hug and a treat. Sometimes it's the smallest comforts that will make all the difference. So Copycat, yes, it is on PC. It is available on Steam. Link is in the description of this video. And I hope you do find this video useful in some way, shape or form. If you don't subscribe already, please do so. And happy trails out there. I'm going to leave you with a little bit more video of the gameplay from the game itself. It's very well made, and I think you'll enjoy it.
Dawn, it's time to learn to provide for the family. See if there's prey downstairs. Perhaps some rabbit or antelope. Valiant effort, Dawn. Well done. Now, which offering would be best for Olive? I guess this will have to suffice. The Wildcat now must share its winnings with the Pride. It seems the Wildcat must try a different strategy.
Olive, are you there? It's Sherry, the nurse from the hospital. How are you feeling today? Please let me in, Olive.
Hey, Mum, I assume you just went on a walk because the nurse just called me. Ring the hospital when you get back to arrange another appointment time, okay?
As they say, when opportunity knocks, one must spread paint all over the house. That'll surely bring Olive out of her slumber. Why don't we try to get paint in every room? Wouldn't that be a jolly old time, Dawn?
Thank you.
be destructive. The wildcat must wake Olive up. Ah, we're back to the place Olive had her fall. Do you feel any remorse for leaving her all alone last night? Out, Olive. Look at all the mess we're making. The bigger the bang, the better. Is this what heaven feels like? Wildcat must choose her hiding spot. Quickly now, Dawn, with haste!
Come with me upstairs.
Here. The paramedics will take care of you now. We're going to go to the hospital. I promise it will be okay. I love you. Be careful, don't bump her. God, easy. Easy now.
After hours of being a scaredy cat, Dawn finally falls asleep under the entertainment unit.
You're home now. Relax. Sit here, Mum. I'll get you some water. You. Please leave my mum alone. She doesn't have the energy to look after a pet. I thought you'd have taken the hint last month when I kicked you out the first time. Don't you hiss at me. You don't belong here. Do you understand, cat?
The wildcat must pull herself together. Let's get back inside. No, Dawn, I think you're stuck. Don't take it personally, it's not you, it's just a really small hole. Wriggle free from your collar, come on!
You again.
Mum, get back inside. You're not well. Leave the damn cat.
No, she's my pet. I look after her. All right, relax. Let's bring her in.
Wait, what just happened? Let's head back to the house.
Look so dirty, Dawn. And where's your collar?
Dawn, are you thinking what I'm thinking? For a stranger, that cat is oddly comfortable inside the house. Maybe Olive didn't see you.
That's enough action for one day, Mum. Put the cat down. Here, take your medication. It'll help you sleep. Let's put you to bed.
I'm sorry for all the trouble.
It's fine, really.
Why, you're not scared of heights, are you, Dawn? Perhaps it's time to find Olive. The wildcat has soft toe pads which help them walk silently through their habitat, or in this case, scale the side of an aging house.
Enough. That's enough. Everything will be all right.
If that's the original Dawn who went missing, does that make you the copycat?
Thank you.
The territory of the Wildcat is vast and unexplored. Who knows what secrets it hides? Through millions of years of evolution, the human has learnt to protect their precious milk source. But little did they know, felines have mastered gravity and have a few tricks up their proverbial sleeves. The Wildcat should come up with a plan to get her companion back. Let's search around to find clues.
Oh my gosh, shut up, shut up, shut up, please.
I told you not to feed the cats.
Thank you. Oh, that stray's at the door again.
The wildcat ain't no dog. But, boy, playing with this soccer ball is fun.
Go away!
Pepperoni's back.
The ability to bring prey proves the value of the feline hunter. Dawn, this is exactly what we need to get back home. Come on, Dawn. Hunt the bird. The wildcat always lands on her feet. Except, it seems, you. Since Egyptian times, cats have always been celebrated for their cognitive and motor skills. Let's not have a repeat of the butterfly fiasco, shall we? The wildcat sets its sights on the defenseless baby bird. It steadies itself before pouncing. Dawn, it's time to secure your prey. Don't hesitate. This is how it works in the wild. Don't look so smug, Dawn. You didn't really hunt the bird, you just knocked it out of the tree. It was a baby, after all.
Spit it out! Oh, thanks. That's very kind of you. What happened to you, little one? Oh, let me just wipe the mud from your face. Stay still. Aren't you a sweetie? You look just like my cat. I'd love to look after you, but I already have a pet. Shh! No meowing, or my daughter will think that I look after every cat on the street. I'm barely allowed to take care of one. Oh, don't look at me like that. I'm sorry, darling. Run along now.
The wildcat must pull herself together. Doubt is a sign of weakness.
Kiara, come here, darling. Puss, puss, puss. Kiara, it's dinner time. Kiara! Oh. Go home, you. Shoo!
The wildcat grows hungry. Bet you wish you had that milky coffee to lap up instead of leaving the cup at Olive's door.
I love you.
I love you more than you know.
Many wildcats roam for up to 2 hours daily, traveling large distances for their next meal.
Everything's yours.
I have to go.
Where are you going?
Away from you.
Big cats are considered apex predators in their respective ecosystems, but there comes a time, Dawn, when it's convenient for the wildcat to stay on the, how should we say, the quiet side? I'm sure he's a good boy, but we don't want to stick around to find out. Now a good time to sneeze? I don't think so. It's right. It's just at the back of my throat. You know, it's really. It's just. No, I'm good. We're fine. for it, Dawn. You're nearly there. I think we've been spotted. Run! This is no time to dilly-dally, Dawn. Let's get going.
I'm gonna see who he belongs to. You go back to bed, Mum. What a night. Shh, baby, it's all right. The dog's gone. You're safe. You're all muddy. Why, aren't you that wee cat that stopped by the other day? I'll be right back, honey. What is it, sweetie? You can tell me. It's time for me to go back to bed. I can't take you inside, honey. I already have a cat. Sorry. You've been through a lot tonight, so take care now.
Olive doesn't remember who you are, Dawn.